Hi, I'm George, you're on Public Spot. Today, I will show you how I set up Terraform Cloud as remote backend to my infrastructure code. So, let's start coding. So one of the important elements to writing code for your infrastructure is the ability to version control the changes to your infrastructure. And this actually accounts for several things. One is the infrastructure's ability to stay idempotent. Secondly is for your infrastructure to be able to recognize intended changes as a result of, say, a code change to your infrastructure. And then lastly is identifying occasional drift of your infrastructure as a result of a break fix or any other manual intervention that would result to changes to your infrastructure. In Terraform, this is mainly what we use state files for. I won't be getting into too much detail on state files on this video, so if you want to learn more, I'll put some links in the description below. Generally speaking, state files are stored depending on how the backend configuration is set up on your Terraform code. So if you don't have any backend configuration, the state files will be stored locally. So if you are just learning Terraform, I think this is fine. This is not a problem. Otherwise, this approach is not advisable because of several things. One is it makes your state files not portable. And then secondly, if you run into problems on your machine, you compromise and you run the risk of losing your state files, basically. And then thirdly, if you're working in teams, it would be a challenge to get everyone else access to the state files. So essentially, you lose the ability to collaborate. In one of my earlier episodes, I showed how I set up AWS S3 Bucket as a remote backend. And on this episode, I will show you another option. And that option is Terraform Cloud. I'll put some links in the description below that will provide more details about Terraform Cloud that you can go and have a look. But on this episode, I will jump straight into the steps relevant to creating a free Terraform Cloud account and the actual use of Terraform Cloud as remote backend to store state files. So for a start, let's go and visit the Terraform Cloud website to create the account. And then in here, I'll just scroll down and find the free account link. And then I'll start filling in the fields that I need to populate. So after creating an account in Terraform Cloud, this will send you an email that you need to confirm before the system can let you in. After confirming the email notification that I received from Terraform Cloud, this is what I get. So on this page, select Start from Scratch. This next page asks for new organization, so I'll put My Public Spot and then click Create Organization. I'm not going to create a workspace just yet, so I'm going to skip this part. But what I need to do instead is to generate a token that I can use for my Terraform commands later on. So I go to my account avatar all the way to the left of the screen, and then click User Settings. And then go to Tokens, and then click Create an API Token. Put some description on the token. Copy the generated token somewhere and then click Done. Now I will go back to my VS Code and then launch Terminal and then cd to home directory, so it's $home. And inside my home directory, I'll create a file called .terraformrc. I'll open this file in VI and then update it with the contents of my Terraform token. Save that file. At this point, I'm ready to spin up my infrastructure resources and save my state files in Terraform Cloud. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to copy the infrastructure code that I've created from the previous episode and run the Terraform commands. So let's just review the contents. So this is my infrastructure, and let's get rid of the files that we don't need. And then in here, I'll create a new file called backend.tf. And then I'll set the contents of this file to point to Terraform Cloud as my remote backend. So what I've done here is set up an organization property to match the organization that I've created in Terraform Cloud. So let me double check if I set that correctly. So let's go to our browser and then choose an organization. And I've actually set my organization as my-pablospot. So let me fix that one. So go back to my code, change that to my-pablospot. And then I set up a workspace and call it using this name. So I'll save all my changes. And then so now I can start running my initial Terraform commands. So I'll cd to infrastructure and then run Terraform init. So having run this command successfully, the workspace that I've defined on my backend config or backend.tf will be created automatically in Terraform Cloud. So let's verify if that's the case. So let's go to our browser and on our Terraform Cloud, you'll see straight away that there's a workspace that got added in there, and it's exactly the same workspace that I've set up in my config file. I want to be able to control my own Terraform runs instead of getting Terraform Cloud to manage the executions for me. So I need to update the execution mode property of my workspace from remote to local. So the way to do that is open the workspace and then go to settings and general. And then there's an option in here that says execution mode. And so instead of remote, I'll change that to local and then save my changes. With that done, I can now go ahead and run my usual Terraform plan and apply. Let's go back to my VS Code. And then in here, I'm gonna run plan. So we got an error. But I think this is an easy fix. It just means that the local tags have not been defined. So let's create locals.tf. And then in here, we'll define the tags. Save all changes. So before running our Terraform plan, let's export the AWS profile that we will use to integrate with AWS. So with the plan successful, I'll go ahead and run the apply. Now that the Terraform apply has run successfully, if I go back to my Terraform Cloud, I should be able to find my very first state file saved. So let's go to Terraform Cloud. And then from here, we'll navigate to states. And then this is the state file that's created for the very first changes to the infrastructure. Now, to prove that our infrastructure is idempotent, let's try to rerun the plan to see what happens without changing anything. So let's go back to my VS Code and let's run plan. So the plan says no changes, infrastructure is up to date, but just to make a point, let's run the apply. And it says apply complete. Zero added, zero changed, zero destroyed. So now let's try to make a very simple change in the infrastructure code and run the whole process again. So in the tags, I'll add a new tag in here called region. Save all the changes, and then let's rerun the whole Terraform process again. So the Terraform plan was successful and it says there's one change. If we scroll up a little bit, it will say what will exactly be change. So now let's run apply. Terraform apply has run successfully and it says one resource has changed. So the final scenario that I would like to show is the case where the infrastructure is touched manually, like maybe in the case of someone wanting to do a break fix. I will open AWS Web Console and then go to the Lambda function that I'd like to be updated. And then open that Lambda function, go to tags, and in the tags, I'm gonna make a change and add a new tag. Save my changes. If I go back to my VS Code and run the whole Terraform process again, it should show that this has changed. So let's run our Terraform plan. The Terraform plan has completed successfully, and indeed it says one resource is to be changed. And then if we scroll up, it will say the manual change will be removed because it's not part of the code. So let's run the apply. And the apply has completed successfully. Now, if I go back to my Terraform Cloud, so let's open that and then open my workspace and then go to states. And the list that we see here, these five state files that we see here corresponds to the number of times that I ran Terraform apply, which means I've actually committed five different changes to my infrastructure. That's it. As usual, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Send me some likes and share this video if you think someone else might find it useful. And if you could, subscribe and help me spread the word about this channel. Until next time, see ya.